3D printed guitar. Will it bend over time? Will the sound be terrible because of the plastic used instead of wood? Do we need to use special pickups? Let's find out! The full article on the Prusa blog goes really in depth about the whole building process. Here, let's take a look at the most interesting challenges of 3D printing a guitar, so you can make one yourself. For us, the scariest challenge was the tension that the strings apply to the guitar. With a load of around 50 kg, the strings can try to fold the guitar in half, rip the bridge from the body, or severely bend the neck. If you look at the most common guitar designs, here they are, one of the bridges stands out as particularly suitable for 3D printed guitar. Can you guess which one it is? Right, it's Telecaster bridge! The other common guitar designs have a small bridge, sometimes held in place with just two screws. However, the Telecaster bridge is a huge metal plate with up to 5 mounting holes. The leverage on the bridge will be nicely spread across the whole metal plate and the underlying printed part. When it came to the neck, the decision was a no-brainer. We opted to use a real wooden neck. While it is possible to 3D print it, it's such a crucial and delicate part of the instrument, it's worth going for the real thing in order to make an instrument that will be a joy to play. Next, we need to make sure the printed body can survive the string tension. So, the section between the neck and the bridge should ideally be printed in one piece. And believe it or not, it does actually fit on the Mark III. This lets us avoid using any metal reinforcements in the printed parts, which would just complicate a build. So, then the printed part alone must be strong enough to survive the tension. It might be tempting to print it from a material like PETG for the added strength. However, in our case, we're specifically looking for a very stiff material, and good old PLA is fantastic in this regard. If you want to be able to leave the printed guitar in the car on a very hot summer day, pick a stiff material with a higher temperature resistance, such as any of our Prusa mounts filled with carbon fiber. Now that we have this centerpiece printed, we can actually go ahead, buy all the needed hardware and try putting the guitar together. But buying the parts separately can be really expensive. Prepare for the real kicker of this build, the Harley Benton Electric Guitar Kit T-Style. This kit is extremely affordable. It includes all the necessary hardware pre-wired with snap connectors. And it's sold by the German-based music house Thomann, one of the largest music instrument retailers in the world, which means it has fast worldwide shipping. To test if everything fits, we've printed one copy of the middle piece with the default Prusa slicer settings. We attach the guitar neck and the bridge to it, and then attach the strings to the, if you can call it, guitar. And voila, the guitar is functional. It looks rather strange with just the centerpiece, and it's missing all of the electronics, but it plays. There is another concern though, material creep. A solid material can slowly deform under the influence of persistent mechanical stress. And this concern turned out to be true. After a month of the printed part being under the tension of strings, the part was mildly bent. This wasn't a huge surprise, as the default profile in Prusa Slicer uses just two perimeters. Reprinting the part with 7 perimeters and 25% cubic infill solved the issue completely. It's now been a year, that's how long it took to get to creating this video, and it's still perfectly straight. Let's talk about something we've just glossed over so far, the guitar's design. The rudimentary unpainted wooden body included in the T-Style kit comes in handy as a template. You can take a photo of it from the distance, calibrate the photo's dimensions, and trace the position of all holes and openings. With the mounting holes in place, it was time to get creative. We used the spline tool in Fusion 360 to create a general shape inspired by a blend of the Fender Jazzmaster and Mustang guitars. The typical thickness of an electric guitar body is 45 mm. This value was used to extrude the sketch. We then extruded all the holes and slots for the electronics using the template created before. Keeping in mind that all the electronics will have to be connected together, we've subtracted a few cylinders from the body to create tunnels between the cavities. This tiny hole is where the grounding cable will go through. We'll get back to it in a minute. A bigger hole on the bottom edge connects to the main control plate slot. The output jack will be located here. We've also added a big chamfer along the hole top edge. This will make it much more comfortable to play and rest the arm on. With that, the basic guitar model was done. Apart from being too big, the model still lacked some elegance or a fun design twist. By using, you guessed it, hexagons, it will be easy to hide some of the cuts used to split the model into multiple parts. Placing the cuts is fairly straightforward, we just have to make sure that all the parts will fit on the 25 by 21 cm build plate. The last big piece we're missing is the pickguard, which also serves as a mounting point for the top pickup. Its shape is pretty well defined by the surrounding edges, which are simply inset by 3 mm. Having the body split into several pieces has one additional advantage. Each part can be printed with a different color. The color scheme here at Prusa Research is pretty obvious. You can't go wrong with black and orange. One extra color that we love using with the Prusa orange is the complementary blue or teal. Coloring the small bottom right piece with this color really brings the whole model alive. And with that, the Prusa caster model is finished. A lot of 3D printed guitars we've seen looked cool, but they were not actually very playable. There are some important things to keep in mind. The bridge must be perfectly aligned with the neck of the guitar. It must also be the right distance from the neck to allow for proper intonation. Specifically, the 12th fret should be exactly in the middle of the string. Fortunately, the Telecaster bridge has a wide adjustment range for this, but it's still important to make sure the bridge is in the good position to begin with. Lastly, the strings need to be high enough above the neck, so the strings don't hit the frets when vibrating, but also not too high, otherwise it will be uncomfortable to hold them down. Our design keeps all these rules in mind. The cables in the Harley Benton T-Style kit all come with JST connectors, so it's really easy to connect everything together. One interesting thing about the wiring is the one standalone black wire that seemingly doesn't connect to anything. It's used to ground the strings. You'll find a channel in the printed part that goes under the bridge. Strip some insulation from the cable, loosen the bridge a little bit, route the cable through the hole, and then tighten the bridge again so it's touching the cable. Without this grounding, the guitar would be buzzing a lot. Even on fairly expensive guitars, there will always be some amount of buzzing, and we're using budget components, but this will significantly help to mitigate it. Guitar strings come in various thicknesses. By selecting very thin strings, such as 9 gauge, we can lower the stress applied to the centerpiece. They are also typically a bit easier to play and allow for easier bending of notes. With the guitar fully assembled, you can string it and tune it. After you tune the strings, you can adjust the guitar's intonation. The process is fully explained in the article linked below, but in a nutshell, you move the saddle up and down until the string is perfectly in tune, both played open and played on the 12th fret. Now let's find out how it plays. Guitar plays surprisingly well. The strings stay in tune and the intonation is pretty good. Of course, since the components were quite cheap, it can be expected to play better than an expensive Telecaster, but for the price, it's a great result. If you want to make your own Prusa caster, download it from printables.com. As always, it's a free download, so go ahead and give it a try. If you want to create your own design, we are sharing a step file of the basic body layout, which should make it fairly easy to modify. Happy printing and happy playing!